Hello, welcome to the AgriTopers Academy YouTube channel. We are covering 10 pages daily from the latest 12th edition Nimrat Sunda book. Additionally, you will have the opportunity to participate in a high quality quiz based on the same 10 pages. To join the quiz, click on the link provided in the description to join our General Agriculture Telegram group. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel to stay updated and never miss a video. This is the third part of agronomy. In this lecture, we will discuss monsoon, irrigation, and soil moisture constant. So without wasting time, let's start our lecture. First topic is monsoon. The word monsoon has originated from Arabic word mosin, which means season. Monsoon is often referred to seasonal reversal of winds over the Indian Ocean, especially in Arabian Sea. India is situated in the northeast trade wind zone and this trade wind continues throughout the year. Total amount of precipitation in country is around 1194 mm. Our total rainfall generated volume in India is 400 million hectare meter. Average rainy days in country is around 130 days per year. Rainy days is greater than 2.5 mm rains during 24 hours is called as rainy day. The first type of monsoon is the southwest monsoon. Southwest monsoon reaches South India around 1st June of every year and in the middle of July it covers whole India under the grip of rainfall. Its withdrawal starts from western Rajasthan in 1st September to complete withdrawal from whole country by 15th October. It moves at average speed of 30 km per hour. It's called as grand period of rainfall in India. It contributes around greater than 75% of total rainfall in India. In Tamil Nadu, the concentration is only 20 to 40% during southwest monsoon. Since most of the rainfall is received during northeast monsoon. In Jammu and Kashmir, the concentration of rainfall during southwest monsoon is about 35 to 50% and remaining portion is fulfilled from western disturbances during November to April. Southwest monsoon ke two branches hoti hai, Arabian Sea branch and Bay of Bengal. Arabian Sea branch contributes 770 mm rainfall. This moves northward in Delhi. And Bay of Bengal contributes 340 mm rainfall. It moves up to Assam. The second type of monsoon is northeast monsoon. Northeast monsoon is onset at about 15 October and is limited mostly to southern states and withdrawal almost by mid-December. Northeast monsoon generally southern states mein aate hain and ye 15 October se start hota hai and mid-December ke time par khatam ho jata hai. Jabki southwest monsoon 1st June se start hota hai and September mein end ho jata hai. Tamil Nadu gets highest annual rainfall in northeast monsoon followed by Andhra Pradesh. This monsoon is also known as retreating monsoon. It contributes about 50% of total rainfall in India. India ke andar major 75% se zyada rainfall southwest monsoon ki wajah se hoti hai and 15% ki around northeast monsoon ki wajah se hoti hai. Next topic aata hai western disturbances. It moves from west to east direction. It is defined as low pressure or cyclonic circulation in the wind above the surface which moves from western countries to Himalayan mountains. December to March is the main period when western disturbances carry rainfall in north and central India which are very useful for rabi crops and in Rajasthan locally known as Mewat. El Nino is a phenomena that leads to rise in the ocean temperature and affect Indian monsoon, consequent dry weather and drought. River which utilize maximum flow is Ganga. Next topic is artificial rain making or cloud seeding. The application of foreign materials to cloud to induce precipitation is called as cloud seeding. Cloud seeding का मतलब होता है हम foreign materials को use करके artificially precipitation को induce करते हैं और इसे हम cloud seeding बोलते हैं. Cloud seeding, silver iodide or dry ice is applied at 1 nuclei for a liter of cloud air. In dynamic cloud seeding, massive quantities of 100 to 1000 nuclei for a liter of cloud air are applied. And warm clouds generally use sodium chloride. Next topic is weather forecasting. Short range mein इसकी वैल्यू होती है लेस देन 3 डेज और अप टू 72 आवर्स. इन मीडियम रेंज इट इज अराउंड 3 to 10 डेज एंड इन लॉन्ग रेंज इट इज अराउंड ग्रेटर देन 10 डेज. द शॉर्ट रेंज फोरकास्टिंग इज इशूड ट्वाइस अ डे एंड स्पेशली वैलिड फॉर 36 आवर्स. शॉर्ट रेंज फोरकास्टिंग का मतलब है हम एक दिन में 2 बार फोरकास्टिंग कर सकते हैं एंड इसका रिजल्ट 36 आवर तक वैलिड रहता है. द लॉन्ग रेंज फोरकास्ट आर इशूड थ्राइस अ ईयर एंड आर यूजफुल फॉर चूजिंग क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न. लॉन्ग रेंज फोरकास्ट को हम एक ईयर में 3 बार इशू कर सकते हैं एंड ये क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न को सेलेक्ट करने के लिए हेल्प करती है. द प्रिडिक्शन ऑफ मॉनसून इज बेस्ड ऑन स्टैटिस्टिकल ऑब्जर्वेशन ऑफ लॉन्ग रेंज फोरकास्टिंग while synoptic method of forecasting is used for short range forecast. Short range forecasting के लिए हम synoptic method का use करते हैं. NCMRWF National Center for Medium Range Weather Forecasting, it is present in New Delhi. Next, here are some properties of water are given, such as latent heat of vaporization is equals to 580 calories per gram at 0 degree centigrade. Next is heat of sublimation is 680 calorie per gram at 0 degree centigrade. The heat of fusion is 80 calorie per gram at 0 degree Celsius and highest density of water is at 4 degree Celsius. Water expands on freezing is around 9% by volume. Dielectric constant of water is 80. And water has highest specific heat capacity and it is equals to 1 calorie per gram of any known substance except liquid ammonia, which is equal to 1.03 calorie per gram. Next topic is water logging. Water logging is a situation where all the pores, both macro and micro pores, are filled with water temporarily or permanently. वाटर लॉगिंग का मतलब होता है जब भी किसी भी लैंड में वाटर फील कैपेसिटी से ज़्यादा भर जाता है. इससे सॉइल में प्रेजेंट मैक्रो एंड माइक्रो पोर्स वाटर के साथ फील्ड हो जाते हैं, उससे हम वाटर लॉगिंग बोलते हैं. हियर सम डीमेरिट्स ऑफ वाटर लॉगिंग आर गिवन सच एज इट रिड्यूसेस ODR, इट मीन्स इट रिड्यूसेस ऑक्सीजन डिफ्यूजन रेट. नेक्स्ट इज इट रिड्यूसेस रिडॉक्स पोटेंशियल and EH of well-aerated soil which is around 400 to 700 millivolt. EH of waterlogged soil is around 250 to minus 300 millivolt. Denitrification loss more in waterlogged soil occurred. In submerged rice, sulfate are reduced to sulfide that is further reduced to H2S that causes Akyonchi in rice due to toxicity of H2S. Next topic is approach of irrigation scheduling. First is transpiration ratio approach. It means the amount of water transpired by a crop to produce unit amount of dry matter. This is also known as absolute approach. Second is soil moisture deficit approach. For maize and wheat, 25% depletion of available soil moisture occur. For drought resistant crop, 50% depletion of available soil moisture occur. Third is climatological approach or IWCPE approach. It is known as soil moisture index approach. The ratio of IW by CPE serve as soil moisture stress index. Lower the ratio will be more stressful.
It is a scientific approach but not a practical utility. Fourth is critical stage approach. The state of growth when plants are most sensitive to shortage of water and most responsive to correction of deficiency is called as critical stage. क्रिटिकल स्टेज का मतलब होता है जब भी किसी प्लांट के अंदर ग्रोथ की ऐसी स्टेज जिस पर वाटर की शॉर्टेज होने की वजह से सबसे ज़्यादा सेंसिटिविटी शो करता है एंड इस स्टेज में प्लांट्स में डेफिशिएंसी को हम करेक्ट भी कर सकते हैं. यहाँ पर हमने एक टेबल दी है जिसमें क्रॉप्स के साथ इनकी क्रिटिकल स्टेजेस बताई है कि किस टाइम पर उन्हें वाटरिंग की ज़रूरत होती है. तो फर्स्ट क्रॉप है राइस. राइस में क्रिटिकल स्टेजेस होती है बूटिंग, पैनिकल इनिशिएशन एंड फ्लावरिंग. इसमें IW/CPE का रेशो होता है 1.2. सेकेंड क्रॉप है वीट. वीट में क्रिटिकल स्टेज होती है CRI, जिसे हम क्राउन रूट इनिशिएशन स्टेज बोलते हैं. इसके बाद सेकेंड स्टेज आती है टेलरिंग, देन ज्वाइनिंग, देन फ्लावरिंग, मिल्किंग एंड डोइंग, एंड इसका रेशियो है 0.9. नेक्स्ट क्रॉप है मेस. मेस की क्रिटिकल स्टेज होती है टेसलिंग एंड सिल्किंग. टेसल्स एंड सिल्क इमर्ज होते हैं उस टाइम पे इरिगेशन की क्रिटिकल स्टेज होती है एंड इसका रेशियो है 0.9. देन नेक्स्ट क्रॉप इज कॉटन. कॉटन की क्रिटिकल स्टेज होती है फ्लावरिंग एंड बॉल फॉर्मेशन एंड इसका IW/CPE रेशियो है 0.7. नेक्स्ट क्रॉप इज ग्राम. ग्राम में क्रिटिकल स्टेज होती है प्री फ्लावरिंग, फ्लावरिंग से पहले की एंड पॉड डेवलपमेंट की. इसका रेशियो है 0.6. नेक्स्ट क्रॉप है ग्राउंडनट. ग्राउंडनट में क्रिटिकल स्टेज होती है फ्लावरिंग, पैगिंग एंड पॉट फिलिंग एंड इसका IW/CPE रेशो है 0.6. नेक्स्ट इज पीजन पी. इसमें क्रिटिकल स्टेज होती है फ्लावर इनिशिएशन एंड पॉट फॉर्मेशन एंड इसका रेशो है 0.6. लास्ट इज से फ्लावर. इसमें क्रिटिकल स्टेज होती है फ्लावर इनिशिएशन एंड इसका रेशो है 0.4, विच इज लोएस्ट. नेक्स्ट अगेन यहाँ पे एक टेबल दी है जिसमें परसेंटेज इरिगेटेड एंड वाटर रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ मेजर फील्ड क्रॉप गिवन है. फर्स्ट क्रॉप है शुगर केन. शुगर केन में परसेंटेज इरिगेटेड एरिया होता है 93 एंड इसकी वाटर रिक्वायरमेंट होती है 1500 to 2500 mm की. नेक्स्ट क्रॉप इज वीट. वीट का इरिगेटेड एरिया परसेंटेज है 85 एंड इसका वाटर रिक्वायरमेंट की वैल्यू है 650 to 800. नेक्स्ट क्रॉप इज राइस. राइस में परसेंटेज इरिगेटेड एरिया होता है 50 एंड इसका वाटर रिक्वायरमेंट है 1500 mm. नेक्स्ट क्रॉप इज ऑयल सीड. इट्स परसेंटेज इरिगेटेड एरिया इज 25 एंड वाटर रिक्वायरमेंट इज अराउंड 500 to 700 mm. लास्ट क्रॉप इज पल्सेस. पल्सेस का परसेंटेज इरिगेटेड एरिया है 10% एंड वाटर रिक्वायरमेंट है 450 to 700 mm. इसके बाद यहाँ पे कुछ यूनिट्स दी है जिससे हम इरिगेशन वाटर को मेजर कर सकते हैं. फर्स्ट है क्यूसेक. 1 क्यूसेक इक्वल्स टू 28.3 liters. सेकेंड इज 1 क्यूमेक. इट इज इक्वल्स टू 1000 liter. नेक्स्ट इज 1 हेक्टेयर mm. इट इज अराउंड 10,000 liter एंड 1 हेक्टेयर centimeter इज इक्वल्स टू 1 lakh liter. 1 हेक्टेयर meter इज इक्वल्स टू 10^7 liters. नेक्स्ट मेजर ऑफ वाटर हाइट. इट इज इक्वल्स टू 1 atmosphere इज इक्वल्स टू 1,036 centimeter ऑफ वाटर एंड 1 bar इज इक्वल्स टू 1,023 centimeter ऑफ वाटर. नेक्स्ट सम कंजर्वेशन यूनिट्स आर गिवन, दैट इज 1 acre इज इक्वल्स टू 0.405 hectare एंड 1 hectare इज इक्वल्स टू 2.47 acre. अकॉर्डिंग टू द क्रीडा हैदराबाद 1985, प्लॉइंग इज क्लासिफाइड एज शैलो, मीडियम एंड डीप प्लॉइंग. द डेप्थ ऑफ शैलो प्लॉइंग इज इक्वल्स टू 5 to 6 centimeter. द डेप्थ ऑफ मीडियम प्लॉइंग इज इक्वल्स टू 15 to 20 centimeter एंड For deep plowing, it is equals to 25 to 30 centimeter. Watershed management, it may be a natural unit of land whose runoff collects and flows out of the area through a single common outlet into a river or other water body. Classification of watershed are given below. First is macro watershed. It is equals to greater than 50,000 hectare. Second is sub macro watershed, equals to 10,000 to 50,000 hectare. Third is milli watershed. It is equals to 1,000 to 10,000 hectare. Next, micro watershed. It is equals to 100 to 1,000 hectare. Last is mini watershed. It is equals to 10 to 100 hectare. Next is unit number 7, irrigation. Irrigation is the artificial application of water to partially meet the crop requirement. जब भी हम फील्ड में वाटर का आर्टिफिशियली एप्लीकेशन करते हैं जिससे क्रॉप की इवेपो ट्रांसपिरेशन रिक्वायरमेंट की फुलफिलमेंट हो जाती है उसे हम इरिगेशन बोलते हैं. इरिगेशन मेथड्स आर क्लासिफाइड इनटू सरफेस इरिगेशन, सब सरफेस इरिगेशन, स्प्रिंकलर, ड्रिप इरिगेशन एंड टाइफून सिस्टम. Surface irrigation is the most common method of irrigation in India. It includes following methods. इसके अंदर बहुत सारे methods included होते हैं जिसमें first है flood irrigation. Flood irrigation means application of water to the crop by flooding. इसका मतलब है कि हमें crop को soil surface पे flooding के जैसे water apply करना है. This method is practiced where irrigation water is abundant. जहाँ पर irrigation water high amount में present होता है उस जगह पर हम इस method को use करते हैं. It is mostly adopted in wetland rice. It is useful in uniform surface soils with good water holding capacity. इस method को हम ऐसी soil surface पर use करते हैं जिसकी water holding capacity ज़्यादा होती है and generally हम इसे wetland rice में use करते हैं. Now second method is check basin. Check basin, it is the most common among surface method. It is suitable for close growing crops like wheat, groundnut and pearl millet. It consists in running water into relatively level basins which is surrounded by small ridges. Filled with slope up to 3% can be irrigated by using this method. इस method को हम ऐसे areas में use करते हैं जिसमें slope 3% तक present होता है और यहाँ पर इसकी एक limitation दी है कि यहाँ पर हमको बहुत ज़्यादा ridges बनानी पड़ती हैं जिसकी वजह से labor cost बढ़ जाती है. Next method is ring basin. It is suitable for fruit crops. Fourth method is border strip method. In this method, the field is divided into number of strips which are separated by ridges. Soils with a slope of 0.5 to 1% are suitable for this method. It is suitable for all close growing crops on medium to heavy texture soils, but it is not suitable for sandy soil. Fifth method is furrow method. This method is generally used to irrigate row crops and vegetables and it is suited to soils in which infiltration rates are between 0.5 to 2.5 cm per hour. It is ideal for slopes varying from 0.2 to 0.5% and a stream size of 1 to 2 per second. The length of furrows may vary from 30 meter for sandy soils at lesser slope to 300 meter for heavy soils at greater slope. Furrow irrigation is suitable to most type of soil except the sands that have a very high infiltration rate. Furrows are mostly suitable for root and tuber crops. Next method is surge irrigation. The term surge irrigation is the intermittent application of water to the field surface under gravity flow which results in a series of on and off modes of constant or variable time span. This process of on and off water supply and cutoff results in minimized deep percolation and runoff losses, and this method is not popular in India. Last method is cab lubrication. It's an automatic method of surface irrigation. Now, second type of irrigation system is subsurface or subsoil irrigation system. Water is applied into a series of field ditches through underground pipelines, generally followed in Western countries. This method is practiced in Kerala for coconut garden and in Gujarat and Kashmir on sandy loam soils for vegetables. Drip system can be used in subsurface method. Next type of system is sprinklers. Water is applied with pressure to the surface of any crop or soil in the form of thin spray, somewhat resembling rainfall. इस मेथड में हम रेनफॉल के जैसे कुछ वाटर ड्रॉप्स को प्रेशर के साथ अप्लाई करते हैं क्रॉप्स और सॉइल सरफेस पर. दिस सिस्टम कंसिस्ट ऑफ स्प्रिंकलर. इट हैज हेड्स और नोजल विच आर माउंटेड ऑन राइजर्स इन लेटरल लाइंस टेकन फ्रॉम मेन लाइन विच इज फर्दर कनेक्टेड टू अ पंपिंग यूनिट. The rate of spray of water can be regulated and natural rainfall can be simulated. Sprinkler irrigation can be used for almost all crops and on most soil except the heavy clay soil. It is specially suited for fields with steep slopes or irregular topography. If soil erosion is a hazard, it can be used in conjugation with contour bonding, terracing, mulching and strip cropping. Here some advantages of sprinkler irrigation are given. First is, it is suitable for undulating topography and sandy soils. It saves water from 25 to 50% for different crops. Discharge rate is more than 1000 liter per hour. Sprinkler pressure is around 2.5 to 4.5 kg per centimeter square. The water use efficiency can be as high as 60%, much higher to surface method of irrigation. It increases 40% in irrigated area with same amount of water as compared with surface method of irrigation. About 40 to 60% saving in labor compared with surface. It can be used to protect crops against frost and high temperature. Now, fourth system is drip irrigation. This method was introduced from Israel. Drip or trickle irrigation is one of the latest method of irrigation which is becoming increasingly popular in areas with water scarcity and salt problems. ऐसे areas जिनमें water scarcity and salt की problem रहती है, उस areas में drip irrigation and trickle irrigation famous method है. This irrigation is defined as the precise but slow application of water as discrete drops or continuous drops through mechanical devices called emitters located at selected points along water delivering lines. इस method में water delivering lines होती है जिसमें जगह जगह पर emitters present होते हैं and ये emitters precisely और slowly water का application करते हैं. This system involves the slow application of water drop by drop to root zones of crop. इस method से drop by drop water root zones से तक पहुंच जाता है crop की. In this method, water is used very economically since losses due to deep percolation and surface evaporation are reducing to the minimum. Drip irrigation is best suited in water scarcity area where water quality is marginal, topography is undulating or steep, soil depth is restricted, labor is expensive and crop value is high. Next, advantages of drip irrigation. It is suitable for water scarcity area. It saves water to 50 to 70% as compared to surface. Fertilizers or other chemical amendments can be efficiently applied to individual or separate plants. Discharge rate of water per dripper is generally 1 to 8 liter per hour at 1.5 to 2.5 kg per centimeter square pressure. Fertilizer and herbicide also possible to apply with drip. And जब भी हम drip water के साथ में fertilizer का application करते हैं, उस method को हम fertigation बोलते हैं and drip के साथ में herbicides का application करते हैं, उस method को हम herbication बोलते हैं. It is most suitable for widely spaced crop, orchard trees and in greenhouses. Last system is typhoon system of drip irrigation. In sugar cane, modify drip. In this method, a particular water depth maintained at a particular growth stage. इस मेथड को हम शुगर केन के अंदर यूज करते हैं. ये एक मॉडिफाइड ड्रिप इरिगेशन सिस्टम है. नाउ नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज ड्रेनेज. एग्रीकल्चरल ड्रेनेज इज द रिमूवल ऑफ एक्सेस वाटर नोन एज फ्री वाटर और ग्रेविटेशनल वाटर फ्रॉम द सरफेस और बिलो द सरफेस ऑफ फार्म लैंड इज कॉल्ड एज ड्रेनेज. सो एज टू क्रिएट फेवरेबल सॉइल कंडीशन फॉर प्लांट ग्रोथ ड्रेनेज इज नेसेसरी. Drainage method is divided into two types, surface drainage and subsurface drainage. Drainage का मतलब होता है soil surface से excess water को remove कर देना. So first is surface drainage. It is the simplest and cheapest method of drainage. It is most common in India by digging open drains at suitable interval and depth. ये इंडिया में सबसे common method है जिसमें हम कुछ इंटरवेल्स एंड डेप्थ पर डिगिंग कर देते हैं. फर्स्ट इज ड्रेनेज ऑफ फ्लेट एरियाज. ड्रेनेज ऑफ फ्लेट एरियाज हम करते हैं ऐसे एरियाज में जिनमें स्लोप 2% से भी कम होता है. नेक्स्ट इज ब्रॉड बेड इन फरो सिस्टम. फील्ड इज लेड आउट इनटू 120 टू 150 सेंटीमीटर विथ बेड्स एंड 45 सेंटीमीटर वाइड furrows across the slope. About 0.5% slope is provided for free drainage. Crops are sowed on beds having two or more than two rows each. These beds are 15 cm raised. This method are widely practiced in groundnut and in clay soil. Now second method is subsurface drainage. The purpose is to lower down the groundwater level below root zones. Subsurface drainage includes tile drains, it includes perforated pipes, mold drainage, it is suitable for clay soil, vertical drainage, drainage by digging wells is called as vertical drainage. It is practiced in coffee gardens. Next topic is methods of water measurements. First is orifices. To measure the water in comparatively small streams like flow into border strips, furrows and check basins is called as orifices. Second is weirs. It is used to measure the flow in an irrigation channel or the discharge of a channel outlet at the source. The basic equation for discharge through weir is Q equals to CLH. The discharge relationship for suppressed weir is 0.0184 LH to the power 3/2. Third is partial flume. It is a combination of weir and the submerged orifice. It can be used even in relatively shallow channels like irrigation furrows with flood grates. Next is unit number 8, soil moisture constant. First topic is metric potential. The total water potential that is attributed to the solid colloidal matrix of the soil system is called as metric potential. Second is capillary potential. It means the energy with which water is held by soil is defined in terms of capillary potential. Capillary potential ka matlab hota hai ki water and soil ke beech mein kitni energy hai and सॉइल ने वाटर को कितना अच्छे से होल्ड किया है इसे हम कैपिलरी पोटेंशियल बोलते हैं. नेक्स्ट टर्म इज सीपेज. सीपेज मींस हॉरिजॉन्टल फ्लो ऑफ वाटर चैनल इज कॉल्ड एज सीपेज. वाटर लॉस फ्रॉम इरिगेशन चैनल और कैनल इज मेनली ड्यू टू सीपेज. नेक्स्ट टर्म इज गिवन एज परकोलेशन. द डाउनवर्ड मूवमेंट ऑफ वाटर थ्रू सैचुरेटेड और नियरली सैचुरेटेड सॉइल in response to gravity is called as percolation. Next term is infiltration. The entry of water from the upper layer of soil is called as infiltration. Infiltration ka matlab hota hai jab bhi water upper layer se lower layer mein enter karta hai is process ko hum infiltration bolte hai. It occurs in unsaturated soil while percolation occur in saturated soil. Next term is leaching. The downward movement of nutrient and salts from the root zone with the water is called as leaching. लीचिंग का मतलब होता है जब भी वाटर के साथ में न्यूट्रिएंट्स एंड सॉल्ट्स रूट जोन में एंटर करते हैं, डाउनवर्ड मूव करते हैं, उसे हम लीचिंग बोलते हैं। नेक्स्ट टर्म है सैचुरेशन कैपेसिटी। व्हेन ऑल द सॉइल पोर्स आर फिल्ड विद वाटर एट अ टेंशन ऑफ 0 bar इज टर्म्ड एज सैचुरेशन कैपेसिटी। इट इज कॉल्ड एज मैक्सिमम वाटर होल्डिंग कैपेसिटी। नेक्स्ट टर्म है फील्ड कैपेसिटी। द सॉइल मॉइस्चर कॉन्टेंट आफ्टर 2-3 डेज ऑफ इरीगेशन एंड आफ्टर ड्रेनेज ऑफ ग्रेविटेशनल वाटर हैज बिकम वेरी स्लो एंड सॉइल मॉइस्चर कॉन्टेंट हैड बिकम रिलेटिवली स्टेबल। एट द फील्ड कैपेसिटी द लार्जर पोर्स फिल्ड विथ एयर एंड द माइक्रो पोर्स आर फिल्ड विथ वाटर। इट इज कंसिडर्ड एज द अपर लिमिट ऑफ वाटर अवेलेबिलिटी टू द प्लांट्स। The tension at field capacity ranges from -0.1 to -0.33 atm. It is determined with the help of pressure plate apparatus. Next topic is permanent wilting point. The concept permanent wilting point proposed by Briggs and Shands in 1912. They utilized dwarf sunflower as an indicator plant. Soil moisture content at which plants can be no longer obtains enough moisture to meet their requirement and remain wilted unless water is added to the soil. This is called as permanent wilting point. Permanent wilting point का मतलब होता है प्लांट्स की ऐसी कंडीशन कि जिस टाइम पर हम प्लांट्स को एक्स्ट्रा वाटर भी प्रोवाइड करेंगे तो उस केस में भी प्लांट की कंडीशन विल्टेड से सही नहीं हो सकती है, उसे हम परमानेंट विल्टिंग पॉइंट बोलते हैं। इट इज़ द लोअर लिमिट ऑफ अवेलेबल वाटर टू द प्लांट। इस लिमिट के बाद हम कितना भी वाटर प्रोवाइड करेंगे प्लांट्स को, लेकिन प्लांट्स अपनी विल्टिंग कंडीशन को सही नहीं कर सकता है। Although plants are not dead, but they are now in permanent wilted condition and die if water is not added. Soil moisture tension at PWP is about -15 bar or 15 atmosphere. Next point hai wilting coefficient. The percentage of moisture in root zone at the permanent wilting of plant is called as wilting coefficient or wilting critical moisture point. Next topic is available water. The concept of available water was given by Weymeyer and Hendrickson in 1981. It is the soil moisture available for maximum plant use. It is the portion of capillary water held between field capacity to PWP, that is -0.3 to -15 bar. Next topic is ultimate wilting point. The moisture content at which wilting is complete and the plant die is called as ultimate wilting point. Next topic is pH. The term pH was given by S.P.L. Sorensen in 1909. It is defined as the negative logarithm of hydrogen ion activity. It is ranges from 0 to 14. In acidic condition, its value is less than 7. In neutral condition, it is equals to 7. And is in basic condition, it is greater than 7. Next topic is pF value. It is defined by Schoenfeld in 1935. The logarithm of centimeter height of a water column to give the necessary suction. It is expressed in centimeter of water. Here a table is given which is shown pF values and pressure of soil conditions. First is saturated soil. Its pF value is 0 and its pressure is 0.001 atm. In field capacity, the pF value is 2.53 and pressure condition is 1/3. In PWP, pF value is 4.18 and pressure is 15. In hygroscopic point, pF value is 4.50 and pressure is 31. In oven dry soil, the pF value is 7 and pressure is 10,000. Next topic is measurement of soil moisture. Indirect method on the basis of tension. These are following: tensiometer, which is also called as hyrometer. This method is based on principle that the capillary tension increases with decrease in soil moisture content and vice versa. जैसे जैसे soil moisture decrease होता है वैसे capillary tension increase होती है. Tensiometer are sensitive up to 0.85 bars of soil moisture. It is suitable for sandy soils at field capacity or below it in which most of available water below 1 bar tension. It is not suitable for clay soil. Tensiometer are very useful in scheduling irrigation to frequently irrigated crops. Second is electrical resistance. It is also called as Bioncius moisture meter and gypsum block. Gypsum block are containers made up of gypsum, fiberglass, etc. It is based on the principle that electrical resistance increases with decrease in moisture content. जैसे जैसे soil moisture content decrease होता है इसमें electrical resistance increase होता है. It is based on conductivity of electrical low resistance at the field capacity and high at PWP. Gypsum block performs satisfactory measurement in dry soil. It is not suitable for saline soil as salt in soil increases conductivity. It is used for measuring soil moisture tension up to 0 to 15 bar and for scheduling irrigation of crops of delayed intervals. Next is neutron moisture meter. The rapid method used for field or in situ measurement of soil moisture from large volume of soil based on the measurement of number of H plus nuclei present in a unit volume of soil is called as neutron moisture meter. The greater the water content of soil, the more is number of nutrient. Soil में water content जितना ज़्यादा होगा उसमें number of nutrients भी इतने ज़्यादा present होंगे which will be slowed down and vice versa. This is the best method at present available for quantities estimation of changes in soil moisture. Fourth is pressure member and pressure plate apparatus. It is used for laboratory measurement of soil moisture potential. Generally, it is used for estimating field capacity, PWP and moisture content at different pressures. It is suitable for measuring soil moisture tension at 0 to 15 bar. Next topic is soil moisture characteristic curve. A curve showing relationship between the energy status of water, that is tension and amount of moisture in soil. The soil moisture characteristic curve for sandy soil is L-shaped and for clay soil is I-shaped. Next topic is ET, evapotranspiration. The total amount of water lost due to transpiration by crop and evaporation from the soil surface during a specified time from a particular area is called as evapotranspiration. Evapotranspiration का मतलब होता है plants की surface से कितना water transpiration से loss हो रहा है उसे हम evapotranspiration बोलते हैं. Evapotranspiration constitutes nearly 99% of the total water uptake. Next topic is potential evapotranspiration. The concept of PET was given by Thorndwett in 1948. Next topic is measurement of ET. ET can be measured by lysimeter. It consists of growing of crops in large containers installed in a crop field measuring their water loss and gains. ET and leaching losses can also be measured by lysimeter. Next is soil moisture depletion studies. Depletion equals to FC minus PWP into D into DB, where FC is field capacity, D means depth, PWP means permanent wilting point and DB means bulk density. Next is ET can be measured by evaporation data. USWB class A open pan evaporimeter. It is standard evaporimeter most widely used by agrometeorological observatories. It having diameter of 120 cm with a depth of 25 cm and it filled with water up to 20 cm. It is painted white. Evaporation is expressed as mm per day. Second is sunken screen evaporimeter. It is developed by Sharma and Destin in 1968. It is used to measure evaporation under field condition. It is determination of PET by ET ratio, which according to them varies from 0.95 to 1.05. Third is portable evaporimeter. It was developed in Israel in 1984 to measure evaporation for very short periods. Next topic is consumptive use of water. It is defined to designate the losses due to evapotranspiration and the water used by plants for what its metabolic activities. CO equals to ET plus water used in metabolic activities. About 99% of water loss in plants due to evapotranspiration, only 1% of water is used in actual metabolic process. Next topic is estimation of PET by ET. First method is Penman method. It is developed by Penman 1950 for estimating evaporation for free water surface. It is most accurate estimation of ETO, as it utilizes all meteorological parameters responsible for ET. Second is water use efficiency. It is the yield of a marketable crop produced per unit of water used in evapotranspiration, or the water use efficiency equals to the dry matter produced per unit of water used, and it expressed as kg per hectare mm. Water use efficiency are of two types: crop water use efficiency and field water use efficiency. Crop water use efficiency is the ratio of crop yield to the amount of water depleted by the crop in the process of evapotranspiration. WUE of crop equals to Y upon ET. Y means yield and it is divided with evapotranspiration. Second is field water use efficiency. It is the ratio of crop yield to the total amount of water used in the field. Water use efficiency equals to yield divided by water used in field. Next topic is water use efficiency of major field crop. यहाँ पर field crop के साथ में उनकी water use efficiencies दी है kg per hectare mm में. First crop is finger millet. Its water use efficiency is equals to 13.4 kg per hectare mm. Next is wheat. Its water use efficiency is around 12.6. Next, groundnut 9.2, sorghum 9.0, pearl millet and maize 8.0, and rice. It has water use efficiency 3.7 kg per hectare mm. नेक्स्ट, यहाँ पर कुछ टर्म्स दी हैं क्रॉप से रिलेटेड, जैसे कि फर्स्ट है क्यूरिंग. इट इज प्रैक्टिस्ड इन टोबेको एंड टी एंड ऑनियन. नेक्स्ट इज स्ट्रिपिंग. इट इज प्रैक्टिस्ड इन जूट. निपिंग. इट इज एग्रीकल्चर प्रैक्टिस विच इज फॉलोड इन ग्राम एंड कॉटन. नेक्स्ट इज रैपिंग. इट इज फॉलोड इन शुगर केन. Next is propping. It is practiced in banana, and threshing. It is followed in sugarcane. In the next table, oil percentage in field crops are given, such as first crop is coconut. Its oil percentage is around 60%. Next is sesamum. Its oil percent is around 46 to 52. Groundnut 45%. Castor 35 to 58%. Safflower, its oil content is 24 to 36%. Rapeseed and mustard is having 33 to 39% oil, and soybean is having 20% oil content. इसके बाद यहाँ पर cereals का protein content दिया है. First is rice. Rice में protein content होता है 6 to 7%. Maize में होता है 10%. बाजरा में होता है 11 to 12%. Wheat में 11 to 12%, sorghum 10 to 12%, and barley 11.5%. Almost cereal में protein content होता है 10 to 12 के बीच में, and pulses में होता है more than 20 and less than 25, means around 20 to 25. यहाँ पर पल्सेस का प्रोटीन कंटेंट दिया है, जैसे कि फर्स्ट है ग्राम, इसका प्रोटीन कंटेंट होता है 21.1%, पी 22.5%, मूंग 25%, काउ पी 23.4%, लैंटिल्स 25%, अरहर 21-25% एंड उरद 24%। नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज प्रोटीन कंटेंट इन ऑयल सीड्स। सोयाबीन में प्रोटीन परसेंट होता है 42%, सिसेमम में होता है 18-20%, सेफ्लावर 40-45%, ग्राउंडनट 26% एंड लीन सीड 36%। सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट टूडेज लेक्चर। मिलते हैं अब नेक्स्ट वीडियो में। इसके बाद हम नेक्स्ट वीडियो में क्रॉप्स का क्लासिफिकेशन एंड क्रॉप प्रोडक्शन पढ़ेंगे, जिसमें हम क्रॉप और उनके कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स पढ़ने वाले हैं। सो थैंक्स फॉर वॉचिंग एंड डोंट फॉरगेट टू लाइक, सब्सक्राइब एंड शेयर।